Hello everyone, I'm Freaky and welcome to the video. Let me ask you guys something. How many of you have been told by your friends online or news on the internet or just random people on the internet telling you the ending or whatever's going to happen in a movie that you haven't seen yet but was planning on watching it anyways? Or the movie was taking so goddamn long to be released in your country that you decided to go and look up on what happened because you just couldn't stand waiting any longer, wanting to know what the hell happened in that movie or series or whatever. Because this has happened to me both times. And one of those was with King Kong vs. Godzilla, where somebody told me in the comment sections that, ha ha ha, Godzilla won. Or the other time, when Dragon Ball Super Broly came out in Japan, I was trying my best not to try and spoil myself and not read or look up what's going to happen in the movie. But sadly, I'm weak. So yeah, it took too long, so I decided to look up what was going to happen in the Dragon Ball Super Broly movie. So yeah, I'm weak-willed, and you can't get away from information on the internet. Because, come on, let's face it, it's extremely hard to avoid the internet these days, even if you are trying to avoid the internet entirely. Because you got people texting you, you got people commenting on you, and telling you what happened, or some random article comes up and says, hey look, Godzilla won. Yeah, those stupid notifications and stupid news popping up. And I'm sure that you guys have come across this as well. And you know what? I'm sick of it. The internet is part of our everyday life. And notifications are always popping up or somebody tells us. I'm telling you guys, it is an absolute nightmare trying to avoid spoilers. But you know what? I have a solution. But it's going to require every single country in the world to have a compromise. But hey, listen to my idea and tell me if you guys think this is a good idea. Okay, we all know that there's hundreds of movies going on every single day around the world, from English to Spanish to French, basically all over the world. Chinese movies, Japanese movies, American movies, Canadian movies, English movies, and all that stuff. When it comes to unknown movies, you know, like standalone movies that doesn't have a franchise, like Brightburn, or look at it this way. Think of a movie franchise from either Marvel, Pokemon, Dragon Ball Z, the Godzilla franchise, the Kong franchise, the Transformers franchise, the Avatar franchise, you know, whatever franchise you're into. Now let's just say, for example, there was a new movie of Dragon Ball Super that was coming out, which there is. I believe it's going to be coming out in the year 2022. And by the time I've made this video, I really don't know who the next villain's going to be. So I just want to give you guys a little bit of an heads up. Anyways, I know for a fact there are loads of fans all over the world that loves this series. Do you guys remember that crowd that was watching Dragon Ball Super with Frieza, Goku and 17 fighting against Jiren? And everybody was shouting, Frieza, 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 Goku, Goku. And when I saw that, I mean, I couldn't believe that there were so many dedicated fans in Mexico. I mean, that it was just unbelievable. And also, when Broly came out, I also learned that there was loads and loads of fans all over the world that really wanted to see Broly. I mean, yeah, I knew there was like Dragon Ball Z fans all over the world, but not this big. I mean, come on. I wasn't expecting Dragon Ball Z to be this big, and it makes me proud to be a Dragon Ball Z fan. I mean, to see all these fans from all over the world to watch Dragon Ball Z just brings a tear to my eyes. So yeah, I'm going off track. Anyways, yeah, let me get back to the point. Now, as we all know, Dragon Ball Super Broly came out in Japan first. We all know this. And then other countries followed suit. Some took a few hours, some took a few days, a week. And some countries didn't get Dragon Ball Super Broly in theatres. And if I remember correctly, even India has Dragon Ball Z fans. And I don't think they actually got Broly in the theatres. I mean, come on, India has over about like a billion people living there. And you're telling me that they didn't show Dragon Ball Super Broly? Really? But hey, I'm going off memory here. If I'm wrong, please let me know in the comment sections below. I'm not sure if they eventually let Dragon Ball Super Broly in theatres in India, but, anyways, again, there was countries who had it out from a few days to a week, maybe even 2 weeks, and there was countries that didn't have Dragon Ball Super Broly in theatres at all. And you know what? I feel really bad for those who didn't get Dragon Ball Super Broly in the theatres, so to my fellow fans, I'm really sorry. And as for the rest of us, who is waiting for Dragon Ball Super Broly to come into our countries, we do try to avoid spoilers as much as we can. But then you get somebody telling us in the comment sections or on our social medias or news telling us what happened, even when we're trying to avoid spoilers, And then you get the weakest of us thinking, you know what, screw it, I'm just going to read up what the hell happened on the Dragon Ball Wikipedia. Man, I tell ya, I really, really do tell ya. This is a huge problem for the international Dragon Ball community, and not just for the international Dragon Ball Z community, but for every fandom in general. Again, like Transformers, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, Marvel, Justice League, well, DC. Basically, every single franchise that has a huge following behind it from all over the world. So this is what I think they should do. The studio or company that's distributing movies or series or whatever should hand over the rights to the movie and should be given at least a few days to get everything set up and have it dubbed. And then when all the dubbing is done for all the countries in the world, from English to French to Chinese or whatever, all the theatres around the world should open on the one day for that movie. Like, for example, like the new Dragon Ball Super movie. All the theatres from around the world should play that movie on the same day when it's released in theatres. Okay, basically, it should be shown internationally on the same day. That's what I think they should do. But it's only for franchises, not just individual movies. I mean, with individual movies that doesn't have a franchise, people can watch those anytime they want, with a less likelihood of spoilers. But when it comes to a fandom, again, like Dragon Ball Z or Transformers or whatever, it's extremely hard to avoid spoilers, especially when you're always on the internet. So that's what I think that all theatres around the world should do. Have the movie come out in all theatres around the world that has a huge fan base on the same day. I mean, the fans could see it as one big massive celebration for all the fans from around the world to enjoy it at the same time. Well, near enough the same time because, you know, the old time zone thing. But you know, near enough. Everybody will be happy and having a good time. It'll be an all worldwide event. Everybody will be watching it at the same time. Again, near enough. And no spoilers. Barely any waiting. All the fandoms from around the world will be happy. No asshat saying, ha ha ha, guess what? Godzilla won against Kong. Okay, that's just an example, but you guys know what I'm trying to say. So, what do you guys think? Is this a good idea? Do you think that every single theatre in the world should show a movie from a franchise all on the same day? Please let me know in the comment section below and let's get the discussion going. I'm Geek Freak. Peace out.
Thank you guys for watching.
And if there's a series you want me to check out and review and give my thoughts on it, or if there's a top 10 list you want me to do, or any reactions or responses or rants on anything geeky, just leave links and comments in the comment sections below and I'll get to them as soon as I can.
Don't forget to like, subscribe, put the bell on, share this video, and leave a comment in the comment sections below. And as for my social medias, I'm literally freaking everywhere. I'm on most video platforms, social medias, forums, and support sites. It's best to pause the video and see where I am. Literally all of this is down in the description box below. So if you want to go and check those out, please do. I'm Geek Freak. Peace out.